Hey there, is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
Church Online. We are so glad to have you join us here today. One of the opportunities we offer here at Life Church is our Growth Track class. We design Growth Track with you in mind to help you in your journey with God.
Another opportunity we offer you here is a small group discussions. This is a chance for you to meet new people at Life Church and get connected.
If you'd like to know more about these classes or know more about Life Church in general, please send us a message on Facebook.
If you would like to get our latest updates, like us on Facebook and follow us on Instagram. Thank you for joining us here today.
And we hope you enjoyed today's service.
Oh, Welcome to Life Church Online. We are so glad that you have joined us today. And today we're going to continue our series Restart. And it's the beginning of a new year. And we're just getting back in focus and realignment with what God wants for our life. You know, last year was quite a year that we had. And it's just a continuation into the new year of what has been going on with this pandemic. But I want to tell you something. I really believe that God is doing some things behind the scenes. He's working in our lives. And I believe he wants us to recognize that. And today I want to talk to you on this thought and this idea. It's really a signature of God. It's one of God's attributes, and that is about freedom. The freedom that comes in knowing God. You know, we have four values in our church, or four purposes of our church. And it's number one, to know God. Number two, to find freedom. Number three, to discover your purpose. And number four, to make a difference. And I believe that by knowing God, you can experience all of those things in your life. And one of the first things we experience is that freedom. And today I want to talk about the freedom that can be found in God. And here's a scripture I'd like to start off with in Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. It says, "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery." And simply that scripture tells us that it is for freedom that Christ has set us free. He wants us to experience the freedom that he has for us. And 2 Corinthians 3:17 says it like this. It says, "Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom." And you know, in a new year, there's a lot of resolutions, and we try to prepare ourselves for a brand new year to start off fresh. And you know, we can do those things, but if we don't have a purpose and we have the Spirit of God in our life, then we're just doing it out of our own ability and out of our own strength. But if we're going to follow Christ and go on that journey with God, I want to tell you something. It happens through the Spirit's power. It doesn't happen through my power. It doesn't happen through your power, through your abilities, but it happens through the Spirit's power. And I think sometimes as believers, we have kind of adopted the attitude that if you're not careful, you can become religious in your rituals and religious in how you approach God. And God doesn't want us to be religious. He wants us to understand that there's a new covenant. There's a covenant called grace. And we live by the grace of God. And we live because God gave us a gift of salvation. And he provides that for us. And we do not earn that. We do not do any good works to try to obtain that. But what we do is we believe and we trust God. And we look to God as our Heavenly Father and believe that he can give us what we need in our life. He is the one that provides salvation. And today I want to talk about that freedom that comes in knowing God, that freedom that comes in experiencing the power of the Holy Spirit in our life. So when we talk about freedom, what do we mean by that? There is no real freedom in your life in living without boundaries. God has a better way. And I want to encourage somebody today that if you think that freedom comes that way, you're missing the real freedom, which is the freedom of God that can bring life and hope and peace and joy to your life, even in the middle of a pandemic, in the middle of trouble, in the middle of job loss. God can bring freedom and help to you, and you can know that you have a peace when you lay your head on your pillow at night. Living with no boundaries is not really freedom. It's actually bondage. When you live doing whatever you want to do for your own selfish desires and your own ego, that's not freedom. In fact, there's nothing free about that. It only creates more problems and more frustration in your life, because real freedom comes in the way in which God called us to live, and that is through his word. And then there's another aspect about freedom, living with our own boundaries, having our own set of boundaries, our own set of ideas, our own philosophies. I just want to tell you today, God has a better way. The Bible says, "His ways are higher than our ways. His thoughts are higher than our thoughts. Even as high as the heavens are above the earth are his ways higher than our ways." And so God has a way that is right. And there's a way that seems right to a man, but the end thereof is death. But when you live in God's boundaries, that's where the freedom happens. I want to encourage you today to really lean in and look at God's word and align yourself to the Bible, because when you do that, you'll start to experience the freedom that God has for us. It's through the Word of God. It's through making God's Word your daily bread, living by it, talking it, walking with it every day, using God's Word in your everyday life, and letting God's Word become your daily lifestyle. God's boundaries aren't restraining us, even though sometimes I hear people say, oh, you're just a Christian, you can't do this and you can't do that and you can't do this. Well, the reality is I choose to live this way. And because I choose to live this way, I have experienced the freedom that only God can give. And I want you to know today that you can have that freedom too, even though you may feel like where you're at in your life right now is impossible. Maybe it seems like your life is just filled with difficulty and problems. I'm telling you, there is freedom in the middle of the problems that you have because God loves you and He cares about where you are, because it is for freedom that He has set you free. It's not just because He has something that He wants you to do and not do. He has something that He wants you to experience, and that is freedom. More than anything else, God wants you to experience the freedom that He has through Jesus Christ, His Son. Freedom is really living under the lordship of Christ. When you make Jesus the Lord of your life, that's where real freedom starts to happen. Jesus is the way. He is the truth, and He is the life. And through Him, we find hope. We find every good gift that we need. And this is where freedom happens, in the presence of God. And let me say this too. Sometimes we get stuck in our past, and we let our past become a barrier for the present that God wants to do in our life. Don't let your past hold you back from what God wants to do right now, today. God is doing a new thing. Can you see it? Isaiah the prophet said. Can you see the new thing that God is doing? Can you perceive it? Because if you can see it, if you can just begin to believe it and up and live in it, God's word, you'll start to see God's hand working in your life. Let's go back to that verse of scripture again in 2 Corinthians 3:17. It says, now the Lord is the Spirit. He says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit becomes Lord in your life, that's where freedom is. So when you allow the Spirit of God to become what guides you and what directs you, when you're filled with the Holy Spirit, that Spirit will empower you to have freedom like you've never had before. I'm telling you, it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. I remember I used to go into the prison, and in that prison, these men would come out into the hallway and we would have church, and there would probably be about 50 to 60 of them that would gather up and just worship together. And I remember preaching to them about this scripture and talking about how where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Doesn't matter where you're at, doesn't matter how difficult the circumstances are in your life, you can still experience the Spirit of the Lord. In fact, we baptized many prisoners in that prison that found Jesus Christ and gave their life to Him. And I want to tell you today, it doesn't matter where you are in your life. You can be in a prison, you can feel like your life is completely messed up and confused, and you don't know what to do. But I'm telling you, there is freedom in Jesus Christ. And when you get in the presence of God and you start to pray and you start to acknowledge God in your life, that's where freedom starts to happen in your life. And something amazing happens. I can't even describe it. I can't explain how that works. But I know that it works because I've seen God do this in my life. I've seen God bring me out of circumstances and bring me out of depression and bring me out of difficult situations that only God could, when I was able to get into the presence of God and worship God and thank Him. That's when the Spirit of God became alive to me. And in that prison where I would go each week, those prisoners would worship God and they would praise God, even knowing that they were sent there for some of them for a lifetime. They could experience God. You can't lock God out of your life if you learn how to worship God and you learn the things that please God in your life. So what are some of the filters that we need in our life? Freedom filter. What we need is we need to learn how to please God. We need to be pleasing to God. John 8 verses 31 to 32 says, to the Jews who had believed Him, Jesus said, if you hold to my teachings, you are really my disciples. then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. So this is one of the filters of freedom in your life. When you know the truth will set you free. The Word of God, which is the Bible, is the truth of God's Word that will set you free. And then the other freedom filter, is upholding the convictions, living by the convictions that God has put in your heart. If you know what is right and you don't do it, the Bible says to that person it becomes sin. But when you live by the things that you know are right and you don't abandon those values in your life, then you can experience freedom in your life and you can go from one level of freedom to another level of freedom. But when you abandon the values because maybe you feel like you haven't seen the results that you want to see yet, that's where you will begin to lose the freedom in your life. So hold on to the convictions. Romans 14:23 in the New Living Translation says, "But if you have doubts about whether or not you should eat something, you are sinning if you go ahead and do it, for you are not following your convictions. If you do anything you believe is not right, you are sinning." So this is one of the filters of freedom. And then the next filter of freedom is representing God's love. We need to be people that represent the love of God wherever we go. In our families, first and foremost, sometimes the people that we are closest to can be some of the hardest people to love because we've seen their faults and they've seen our faults, and we get accustomed to being around them and it becomes hard. But we have to learn how to show the love of God and represent God's love in our life, because it's through love that freedom really, really shows up in our life. And we start to experience the freedom that comes because we represent the love of God. This is a filter. If we stop loving, then we stop receiving the freedom that God has for our life. Galatians 5, verses 13 through 14 says, "Though I am free and belong to no one, I have made myself a slave to everyone to win as many as possible." So Paul was very passionate about sharing the love of God with every person that he could possibly share it with. Any way that he could, whatever it required of him, he was willing to get out of his comfort zone and allow himself to be representative of the love of God to those people. And I want to be that person that represents Christ and shows the love of God. And that love will be a filter of freedom in your life. If you want freedom, you got to love people. You got to show the love of God, because Jesus came to bring life, and that life to every one of us. He came to bring salvation to all of us because he loved us, and he continues to love us even when we were not very lovable. John 8, verses 34 through 36 kind of sums it up. Jesus replied and said, "Very truly I tell you, everyone who sins is a slave to sin. Now a slave has no permanent place in the family, but a son belongs to it forever. So if the Son sets you free, you will be free indeed." So the Son will set you free when you give your life to Christ. When you belong to him and you no longer become a slave to sin, giving up the life of sin, I'm giving up these things that I used to do that may have brought me temporary pleasure, but today I'm going to live a life that lives within the boundaries of God so that I can have freedom. You know, I know Lithuania celebrates two different times during the year of their freedoms. In fact, just the other day, they celebrated the standoff with the Soviets at the TV tower, and those who stood up and those who got out of their comfort zone and they said, "I'm going to stand up for my freedoms," and they lost their lives. I want to tell you, freedom is never free. There's always a price to pay for freedom. But if you want the true freedom that comes from Jesus Christ, you've got to give your life to him and say, "God, I'm not living for myself. I'm living for you. And Lord, I know there's boundaries in which I should live my life. I want those in my life." Today, I encourage you to align yourself and go after the things of God that bring true freedom into your life. So why don't we just bow our heads and pray right now and thank God for his word and ask him to open our eyes to the things that he wants for our life. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for your love. We thank you so much for your word that brings life, that brings freedom into our hearts and lives, God. Lord, we know that the world does what the world does, and they will try to convince us that there's freedom outside of Christ. And today you said, he that the Son has set free is free indeed. And today I surrender my heart and my life to you. God, forgive me of the sins that I've allowed to control me. Forgive me for living outside of the boundaries that you have for my life. Create in me a clean heart and renew in me a right spirit. I give my life to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I congratulate you today for those of you that prayed that prayer with me. And I know that when you step out and you move in the direction of God, there will be challenges, there will be resistance to that decision that you made, but don't give up. Hold on to the freedom of God. Hold on to God, because through him, you will begin to experience the freedom that comes from one level of God to the next level of God. I encourage you to get plugged into small groups that we have available. One of our classes is called Growth Track Class. There you can learn about how you can grow in your relationship with God and in your relationship with others that can encourage you along the way. And also, during this month, we are going to be having a time of prayer on our Zoom call. I encourage you to just join us on Zoom at 7 o'clock on Wednesdays. As we do each and every week, we provide an opportunity for you to give. It's an outlet by which we show God that we love him and that we want what he has for our life. In fact, there's many of you that give each and every week, and I just want to say thank you to those who give generously so that we can share the message of hope with hundreds and even thousands of people all over this city and even around the world. Let's bow our heads and pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for this wonderful privilege that we have to come to you to give, because we know that everything we have belongs to God. This offering is just a token of our gratitude and appreciation for all that you have done. We bring our tithes and offerings to you, and we give it to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us, and let's worship together in this next song.
There is a promise that points beyond my failure. There is a still voice to silence all my fears. Even the worst of my mistakes are miracles in the making. Are miracles in the making. By your strength, purpose. spoken, and I know that it is so.
We are so happy you joined us here today on Facebook Live, and we hope to see you next week.